Hi guys, so in this quick tutorial I'm going to show you how to save a ggplot that you might have created from some of your own data for use in After Effects, just to make sure that the colours match in the background of your ggplot to those that are being used in After Effects. And you might think this was simple just by setting the same hex colour code, but I've had considerable difficulty in the past by exporting my ggplot as a PNG file using ggsave, for example, and then when I use the exact same hex color codes in After Effects and import that PNG, the background of my ggplot is completely different from the color of the background of any solid colors used in After Effects. So this is a nice, quick, and easy workaround that I've found. So here's some code that I've produced. No code shaming, please, but I will put the data and the code in the description, or links to them in the description of the video below. So the first thing I'm going to do is just to set my working directory. So set that to wherever you save the data, and then read in the data, and then generate a plot and call it AEplot. And if I just call the AEplot, this plot just down in the bottom right corner here is what we're going to be saving today. And just note here that the hex color code that we've used for the background is this cyan color, and the code for that is 004040. And so just to demonstrate what I mean about how the PNG files don't show representative colors in After Effects, I'm going to save this as a PNG as you would do normally, maybe with ggsave function. But then what's really going to work is we're going to come over here to the plots panel and use the export function, click save as. And instead of saving it as a PNG, we're going to select EPS from this drop-down menu here. None of the other options, just select EPS. So call it what you want to call it just here, EPS, and save it wherever you want to save it. So I'll save it in my temporary documents. Then come over here and uncheck the maintain aspect ratio box. And we're going to save this as 1920 by 1080, which is the same sort of video width and height dimensions that you get on every standard sort of YouTube video, for example. So the benefit of saving it this way as well is that as from the save plot function here, we can actually save and set the pixel width, whereas ggsave also only allows you to set, to my knowledge, in millimeters, centimeters, and inches. So we'll just click save here, and then we'll pop over across to After Effects just to demonstrate what I mean. We'll create a new composition. We'll just call it comp1, and we'll set the width and the height to 1920 by 1080 with a frame rate of 25 and a background color of black, and just a duration of 30 seconds for now, but we won't need all that, of course. So here's our composition with a black background. And first thing we'll do is we'll just create a solid background layer of the same color as the hex color that we used in our ggplot. So here we go, layer, solid color, and we'll call it deep cyan solid. Again, the width and the height, 1920 by 1080. If we just double click on the color box here, we'll make sure that this hex code is set to the same we used in the ggplot, which is 004040. So that's our cyan color, click OK, and perfect. So now if we just go to where we saved our PNG and our EPS file, to show you the problem with PNGs first, I'll just bring in that ggsaved PNG file and drag that over. Now bearing in mind the EPS file and the PNG file were generated using exactly the same ggplot, and I'll drag that and pop that in here. Now this is quite big, so I'll just zoom out, grab the corner and click, and if I just hold down shift, I maintain the aspect ratio as I zoom in just to rescale this. And I hope what you can see if I just zoom in here is that the color of the background of the ggplot, despite setting the same hex color code, when we save it as a PNG, is much darker than the same hex code color in After Effects for this solid background just here. So here's the ggplot in the center, and here's the solid background. So instead, if we now go back to our file and we import the EPS file and drag that across in here, and then drag that down to our composition, pop that over the top, you notice the color change. Now the PNG file is still there, it's just underneath, so if I toggle the EPS file off, there's our PNG file with the wrong colors, and on top we've got the EPS file with the correct colors. So this is exactly the same ggplot that we've saved, but by saving it as an EPS file and importing it directly into After Effects, we've retained exactly the same colors in the background. I don't entirely know how this works, but this just seems to be a simple way of exporting your ggplot that we can now do all kinds of animations and functions within After Effects with, without it looking a completely different color and having to try and manually find out what the offset on the hex color spectrum is between whatever the PNG hex color code has been interpreted as. a color code in the background, or maybe you want to change the whole color scheme of your animation to fit with your ggplot and you only have a PNG that's already been exported, and show you how we can actually still change the background color so that it is compatible with the colors in After Effects. And we'll be using Adobe Illustrator for that, and I'll put that up in another video. So check that out, and thanks for tuning in, and don't forget to subscribe. Cheers.